I have the Google Pixel 6 right here, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to disable Verity and verification on this phone, as well as the Google Pixel 6 Pro. So if you plan on modding this phone in any way, then you're going to need to disable two things. For example, if you want to install a custom kernel, then you're going to need to follow this guide before you're able to successfully install that kernel. The same goes for root access as well too. If you want to root the Pixel 6 series, then you're going to need to disable Verity and verification before Magisk can be installed. Now, before we can do any of this, we first need to have the bootloader unlocked. I've already covered how to do this in a separate video, and I'll be linking to that video in the description below. So again, before you can begin the steps laid out in this video, you first need to unlock the bootloader of your Pixel 6 or Pixel 6 Pro. Now, after you have the bootloader unlocked, you also need to go ahead and download the firmware for your device that matches the same version of the firmware that you have installed. So I'll be linking to the Google Pixel factory image download page right here in the video description as well. And you're going to go through the version section and match the same version that you have running on your device. You can see we have SDA 1210817.036, and you can find that same version right here. So once you find the version of the firmware that matches what is on your device, go ahead and download that firmware to your PC, and then you're going to need to extract the contents of that file. And once you have that done, we are then going to boot the Google Pixel 6 into Fastboot Mode, also known as bootloader mode. And I've done a video showing the button combination, and I'll be linking to that in the video description as well. Now I'm just going to be using an ADB command, ADB reboot bootloader, to go ahead and force the device into Fastboot Mode. But you can use either method. It doesn't matter if you use the ADB command or the button combination. We just need to get the phone into Fastboot Mode. So here I want to give you the rundown of the firmware. This is the firmware that I downloaded from Google. I extracted the contents of this file and I get this folder. So we're going to go into this folder and we're going to see a number of files here, but you're also going to see another zip file. So again, we need to extract the contents of this zip file, which again, we have these files. These are the files that we want to get to because we need to flash this VBMeta file in order to disable Verity and verification. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this VB image file and we're going to copy and paste, or just move, we're going to move it into the same folder as our ADB and Fastboot tools. So now we have our Pixel 6 in Fastboot mode. We have it connected to the PC with a USB cable. Now if you want to confirm you have a connection here, you can type out the command fastboot space devices and press enter. Just to make sure that you have a device listed here and that it is in Fastboot mode. Once you know that you have a connection, the command we want to type out is fastboot space flash space VBMeta space dash dash disable Verity space dash dash disable verification. And then we're going to do a space after this, and you can either drag and drop your VBMeta file here, or again, since we have the VBMeta file in our Fastboot directory, we can simply start typing out the file name, vbmeta, and press tab to autocomplete that file. So once again, that full command, and I'll be including this command in the video description as well, so you can simply copy and paste that command, is fastboot space flash space vbmeta space disable verity space disable verification with these dashes here. And then we need to tell Fastboot we are flashing this vbmeta file. Once all of that is done, we can go ahead and press enter on the keyboard. You should be told that Fastboot is both sending that file to the vbmeta partition. Now this could be vbmeta A or vbmeta B, depending on the partition you are currently active on. And you should see that it is writing that vbmeta file to that vbmeta partition. And we're looking to get an OK message on both. As long as we get an OK message on both, then we have now disabled Verity and disabled verification on the Google Pixel 6 and the Google Pixel 6 Pro. Now that we have successfully flashed that vbmeta file with the disable Verity and disable verification flags set as shown, we need to turn our attention back to the phone, make sure that the start option is highlighted, and then we're going to press the power button to select this option. Now, if this is the first time you are disabling Verity and verification, then you are going to need to do a factory data reset. What's going to happen is once you press that power button to attempt to boot back into Android, it's going to boot over into Android recovery. It's going to be an Android recovery screen that says it cannot load Android system, that your data may be corrupt, and that if you continue to get this message, you may need to perform a data reset. So from that screen, you're going to press the volume down button, highlight the factory data reset option, and then press the power button to select it. That is going to perform a factory data reset. And then after that's done, it's going to reboot your phone, and it's going to take you to the Android activation screen as you see here. Once we get here, we are just going to breeze on through the activation phase. And we're just going to boot up into Android like normal. So again, if this is your first time disabling Verity and verification, which is required if you want to root the phone, install a custom kernel or anything like that, you are going to have to do a factory data reset if this is your first time.